Hi, Celebration Downtown families. Guess what? Today we are playing my favorite game again, I Spy. Do you like to play I Spy? Well, me too. It is the best game. I'm gonna describe something in my room. When you spy it, I want you to shout it out. Describe an item hidden in your room. It can be an item that you've placed there or an item that's just in the room. Describe using the color, the shape, the size, or the function. Example, the thing that I'm thinking about is round. It's on the wall. And if you listen really closely, you can hear it go tick, tock. It's black with a gray outside. You're right! It's my clock! What an amazing game! This month, we're spying some amazing things that Jesus did in the Bible. And this week, it's probably my favorite story of all. It's all about how God loves us so much that he sent his son so that we could be forgiven of our sins. Let's see if we can spy what God did.
Ooh, ooh. You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go down to the clubhouse with Ollie and his friends. Let's go down to the clubhouse where wonder.
Friends, and welcome to the clubhouse. It's me, Lucy, and I had the best R project to work on today. But it's super windy outside, and something crazy just happened. The wind blew my circles all over the clubhouse, and now I need you to help me spy them all. Point when you see one. I spy with my little eye a circle that is blue and held by my cuddly friend. Do you see it? Yep, you're good. What should I make with this one? It's blue, like water. Oh, I know. It's the whole world. That was fun. Let's do another one. I spy with my little eye a circle that is brown, and wow, the wind blew it up high. Do you see it? Yes, you got it. Well, actually, this is kind of golden brown, like my favorite food, nice and warm, right out of the oven. It's a pizza. On the count of three, shout out your favorite pizza toppings. One, two, three. Those are so yummy. My favorites are pepperoni and peppers.
Hoo, hoo.
It's Ollie.
Hello, Lucy. Hoo, hoo. Making tasty round treats, are you?
There's so much fun stuff to make with circles.
Crafting with circles is fun, it's true. I know a very special circle, just for you. So let's hear this story. Just follow me through. Hoo, hoo.
Follow me through, follow me through, hoo. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Hello, friends. I'm Aisha, and welcome to my cupcake food truck. Do you want to see today's special? Ta-da! They're my whole lot of love cupcakes. I made them because today's story is about someone special who loves us so, so much. If you're ready for a story, on the count of three, yell, "Tell me a story." One, two, three. Tell me a story. Today's amazing true story is about someone very special who did something only he can do. If you think you know who this very special person is, I want you to shout out his name. Yes, Jesus! Jesus is the very special person, and I'm going to tell you about the most amazing thing he ever did that only he can do. God sent his son, Jesus, to show us how to love each other and to be our friend forever. Wait, where did the heart go? We might need to play I Spy to find it. Get out your pretend binoculars and let's look for it. Ready? Tell me when you see the heart. I spy with my little eye a heart. And look, it's showing us that Jesus taught us how to love others by being a good friend. Wait, where did it go? Let's look for it. Ready? I spy with my little eye the heart right there. Good job, everyone. And look, the heart is showing us that Jesus was a good friend to people who were different than him. Not again. Where did it go now? Let's look for it. Ready? I spy with my little eye the heart. It's showing us that Jesus was a good friend to everyone, even people who made bad choices. Jesus was a friend to everyone. One day, a very sad thing happened. Some angry people took Jesus away and hurt him so bad that he died. Jesus' friends buried him in a tomb and rolled a big stone in front of it. Jesus was gone, and his friends were very, very sad. But on the third day, Jesus did something that only Jesus can do. Jesus came back! Jesus is alive! Yes, Jesus is alive! Say that with me! Jesus is alive! One more time! Jesus is alive! We know Jesus is alive because people saw him and talked with him. Then they wrote all about it so we can know and believe that Jesus is alive! Did you like the story? If you did, give it two thumbs up. Two thumbs up! Oh, hey Ollie, tell me, who can believe in Jesus?
I can believe in Jesus. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who can believe in Jesus?
I can believe in Jesus. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time. Bye.
So there's your story, and it's all true. Jesus is alive, and he's a friend forever to you and me, too.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, what a great story. Jesus wants to be a friend to everyone. That means Jesus wants to be my friend, and he wants to be your friend, too. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say, got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! I spy with my little eye a circle that is gray and right behind me. I'm going to paint this so it looks just like the stone that was in front of Jesus' tomb. The stone got rolled away because Jesus is alive.
Look and see how Jesus
I love hearing stories about Jesus. It's so much fun to spy all the things that he has done. This week's story reminds us of a memory verse this month. It says, "These are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God." John 20:31. I know that I can believe in Jesus. Did you know that you can believe in Jesus too? Say it with me. I can believe in Jesus. Let's pray and thank God. Jesus, thank you so much that you can forgive our sins. Lord, we ask that you'd forgive us of our sins and that you'd help us to believe in you. God, we thank you for sending Jesus for our sins, and we ask that as we go around this week, that we would draw near to you and love our neighbor just like you love us. In Jesus' name, amen.